What the hell is the world coming to?
As I went home on a Monday night, as drunk as drunk could be, when I saw a horse outside the door, where my old horse should be. So I called my wife, and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me, who owns that horse outside the door, where my old horse should be. She said, you're drunk, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and silly cannot see. That's a lovely sow that me mother sent to me. For many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, a saddle on a sow, sure I never saw before. As I went home on a Tuesday night, as drunk could be, where I saw a colt behind the door, where my old colt should be. So I called my wife, and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me, who owns that colt behind the door, where my old colt should be. She said, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and silly cannot see. That's a lovely blanket that me mother sent to me. For many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, but buttons on a blanket sure I never saw before. And as I went home on a Wednesday night, as drunk could be, where I saw a pipe upon the chair, where my own pipe should be. So I called my wife, and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me, who holds that pipe upon the chair, where my old pipe should be. She said, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. That's a lovely whistle that me mother sent to me. It's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, tobacco in a whistle, sure I never saw before. As I went home on a Saturday night, as drunk could be, where I saw two boots beneath the bed, where my old boots should be. So I called my wife, and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me, who owns those boots beneath the bed, where my old boots should be. She said, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. There are two geranium pots me mother sent to me. But many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, the laces in geranium pots I never saw before. Well, as I went home on a Sunday night, as drunk could be, I saw a head upon the bed, where my old head should be. So I called my wife, and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me, who holds that head with you in the bed, where my old head should be. She said, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and silly cannot see. That's a baby boy that me mother sent to me. Ah, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, but a baby boy with new whiskers on sure I never saw before.
Just looking at the sign here, St. Patrick's Day Parade, 3:30 p.m. Free goodies for children. Friendliest place in Ireland. €1,000 for the best float. Hey, you want to take the sign down, you know. St. Paddy's Day Parade, but cancel, lad, you know. You want to take that sign down, you're going to confuse folk.
Well, I never did call and I never did toe the line. Nobody is a master to me, I ain't that kind. I just put on my traveling shoes. If you want to win, you just can't lose the time or stay behind. Well, I was born to run, to get ahead of the rest, and all that I wanted was to be the
all it does is just makes life difficult. Hi, so this is what we have now. All of these have to be strapped. So the far side has to be done now. So, next thing, straps and ratchets. One, two, three, four, five. So we have to have one on each, which is not too bad. Just one across here, one across the front wheels, which ain't too bad. So, let's tie them in there. People are telling me the last time I was doing this wrong. I probably was. I have my own way of doing it. I'm pretty sure it's not the right way, but you know what to say, if it's not broken, don't fix it. Thank you, that ain't going anywhere. I have to do it there. Well, that's one, you see, there. It's not a big job. It's not a big job to strap them down, because there's only one goes on each. Only one goes on each. So there's the other side of it, you see. The other side of it. Okay, number two. Hopefully I'll be able to reach that one. Thank you. Oh, good. A little bit more accurate this time. Okay. This job is impossible. Doing this is impossible. Unless you actually open the side of the trailer, you just can't do it. It can't be done. It just can't be done. Now that's two of them. See, it's not difficult. A little bit time consuming. The biggest problem is opening and closing that curtain. It's a pain in the neck. Now, what I have to do is, what you saw me doing in Dundalk, and what you saw me doing already in Cavan, is using the bowl cutters, which is this. You might have seen that I washed the truck. Yeah, well, I was told it was going to be fixed, so I washed it, but it's still not fixed. They got a switch for it, but the switch is not the problem. So the bowl cutters again, just to tighten these, because you won't tighten them like that with your hand. Two is enough on that. That is really, really, really not going to go anywhere. Same thing again here with this. I got three on that one. Same thing again, that's not going to go anywhere. And this one. See if we can get three on this one. Might well get another one on that. Might get another one on it. Now I got two on it. See? And I make sure that that's locked in position. Make sure that that doesn't open, otherwise it'll just loosen off. So that's four of them tightened, and we just have one more to do. And that's the one that's hiding behind the curtain here. So we might be able to pull the curtain back out of the way enough to get at it. Just about. Pull that back enough just to get at it. Otherwise we have to pull the whole curtain down the other way, and I don't want to do that. That's too much like hard work. If I can squeeze the curtain back a little bit, just to get the final strap on. Aye. It doesn't have to go back an awful long way, but sometimes I try and maybe that's too far. Maybe this one will, maybe catch that, you see. That'll hold it back a bit, you see. All I need is enough just to get the strap on. Oh, that wasn't a bad shot. Matter of fact, that could have been a very good shot. Yeah, I'm a good lad at throwing, you know. The question is, did it come out the far side? Oh, it did. Look at that. Look at that for perfection. That saves me having to pull the whole curtain back. Now, same thing here again. Get the strap, feed it through. eventually. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna need the bowl cutters again, just to tighten it. Okay, see what we can get on this. Should be able to get two anyway. Well, we might get another two. Right. Now, perfecto. So that's done. All I have to do now is just to tidy it up. Okay, so we have one side done there. You see that I've mounted the camera there. These things, these cameras here, you just have to mount them wherever you can mount them. Do you know what I mean? I have it mounted there on the bowl cutters. You know, it's not going to fall off. You know, you'll always find somewhere to put it with a clamp like that on them. You'll always find somewhere to put them. Just tidy up my box. Tidy up the box. They use these rubbers to put over stuff. Like, in other words, if you were trying to use the ratchet on that, put the rubber over to protect the getting marks on the wheels or anything like that. Now, just put the clip back in. That's it, done. Now, just pull the curtain back. As I said already, these curtains are ridiculously heavy. And this may be a nice job on a day like today, but I can tell you, this job, and that wind is fighting against me now, you see. That's a quite a strong wind. Hi guys, good afternoon and welcome to the channel. I would just like to thank everyone, first of all, before I go any further. I put up a post on my YouTube page last week there regarding me finishing doing domestic videos. I just want to clear up a few things. The first thing I want to clear up is that I'm still working for DJ McCardle, and I haven't any plan to leave there at the moment. I'm stopping doing the domestic videos purely because I've covered everything, and I don't want the channel to get into the stage, oh, here's another one of Ned's videos, he does the same thing every week. I don't want it to get boring, so I'm going to give it a break for a while and see if I can come up with some new material. Not exactly sure what direction I'm going to be going in, but I'm not going away, so I will be still around, guys. If I get a chance to do a European video, definitely I'm going to do a video on that. But regarding domestic videos, I've just run out of material for them, really, because I'm more or less doing the same thing every day. To the 380 people that sent me messages, I want to thank each and every one of you. It's really, really appreciated, you know, and people say, oh, I sent him a message and he didn't reply or whatever. I read all the messages and I really do appreciate all the good wishes from you guys. Eventually, I want to go on to European work, and hopefully that's going to happen in the next 12 months. I need to upskill on my video editing, and I need to do another few things, and if I'm chugging out videos every week, I'm not going to get a chance to do that. So bear with me, keep an eye on the channel, and I will give you updates as we go along on my YouTube channel. And thanks a million, as I said, to everyone who sent me messages. Thanks a million, guys. Now, just a few shout outs here. The last few shout outs I'm going to be able to do for a while, and if I've missed you again, I do really sincerely apologize, because, you know, it's very hard to get everybody, but I honestly do my best. Okay, first up, Timmy Coughlin. He just passed his test recently. I think he's from around Kilkenny, did you say, or somewhere like that, Timmy? Well done. Betty Swallocks wants another shout out. Shout out for you. Trucker Jono, I'm apologising because you're one of the guys I missed. Trucker Jono, hello to you. Finon, hello to Finon. He's working for one of the waste companies in Dublin. He's collecting rubbish around DA, so if you see him, give him a wave. Finon, hello. Rick Noble in Rotterdam, I forgot you as well, Rick, I do apologise. DJ Josh Taylor, he's a HGV technician from Wigan. Hello to you, DJ Josh Taylor. Gary Ross in Milton Keynes. Hello, Gary, to you. He works for Maritime Transport. Jack Skelly, Moylehen trailer washer. He works in Moylehen. Jack Skelly, hello to you, Jack. Moylehen International, based in Longford. Jack works in there at the moment. He is a trailer washer. He says he's only 16, so keep it going, Jack. Joshua Goosh, hello to you. Stuart Gibbs from Liverpool. Hi, Stuart. How's it going? William O'Neill asked to say hello to Shay and Casey for London. Now, William O'Neill... Shay and Casey, are they your children? You're based in London anyway, William. Hello to you. Sam Evans, thanks, William, for your kind message. Patrick and Peter Plante from Cork. Hello to you guys. Paddy Trucking, thanks for the message from you from Germany. Paddy is over living in Germany, as far as I know. He sent me a message that he's keep doing a bit of trucking around Germany. Why don't you do a video, Paddy? I'd love to see it. Helen Bell, shout out for you. From that comes in from Martin. Jake Mason. From Lichfield in Staffordshire, hello to you. Hello to Simon and Ian White, to Julian Howells and Phil Gaming, hello to you guys. Carl Johnson from Alaska, United States, hello to you, Carl. Michael Swift, Buxton, Derbyshire, hello to you, Michael. Also to Killian Coscoran. Hello to you, Killian. The Scottish Buckleys from Cove, originally from Cove and Cork. Hello to you. And hello to Finbar as well, because someone posted, Finbar, who is an expressway driver, someone posted his reaction to being given a shout out. And a shout out to Finbar and all the expressway drivers and all the people driving the coaches. I know you're driving around in empty coaches nowadays. And the guys who are on the Wexford bus and all those other companies who are... doing the same basically as us, getting people to and from work. Hello to you anyway. Now let me see where we are. Jack Kelf, he is in Spain as far as I know, and he's an old driver. He used to drive a 141 Scania. Hello to you, Jack. Murray Wood asked me to shout out for Michael, Robert and James. Hello to you guys. Dan Nolan from the UK. Hello to you. He's based in around London, I think. Dan Nolan, hello. Someone asked me, what's the best advice for European driving? Well, I'd say the best advice is a bit like, you know, do you ever hear the saying, measure twice and cut once? If you're not sure, ask somebody, and if you're not sure, get out and walk down a road and have a look. But the most important thing I'd say for anyone starting European driving is, don't panic. That'd be what I'd say. Robert Smith drives for AT Byram in North Carolina. Hello to you, Robert. Nice to talk to you there. Craig Murphy recommended Trucker Josh. I know a lot of people watch him. James Marriott wanted Billy and Mo to do a kind of a song. So I think I did that at the start. I hope you enjoyed that. Jamie Stetchel, hello to you. And hello to Uzi, a UK trucker from Yorkshire. He calls himself Uzi. UK trucker from Yorkshire. John Callan, and greetings from Spain. Hello, John. How are you? Train Sim Videos and Hot Sauce Reviews asked for a shout out. Hello to you. And he asked for a shout out for his girlfriend Linda, who's in Redruth in Cornwall. Hello to you. Hello again, obviously, to Raf and the expressway drivers. To Dylan Nelson, hello to you. To Anthony Rashers, hi, how are you? And hello, especially hello to Mother Mandy, aka Mother Bear. Now, Mother Bear sent me a message. She's unfortunately not allowed to vlog. Her company won't allow her, which is a tragedy, really. But, you know, some companies just don't like it. Mike Davis from Derbyshire, UK, hello to you. Hello to Dunworks. How you keep? Andy Topham. He's basically bought a new truck. Hi, Andy, how are you? He bought a 2019 DAF. He's a subby that does a lot of Spanish work, and he's not doing anything at the moment, and I really feel for you, mate, because that's a real disaster. Nick Crossan from Letterkenny, Derek Dempsey, hello to you. Peter Reynolds from Waterford and Heathrow, hello to you. Let me see, who else have we got? Sam Beale from Sudbury and Suffolk, hello to you. John Rice Senior and Junior, hello, John Rice. To Andrew Hannon, hello, Andrew. And to Andrew Ellison, who's a livestock driver, hello to you. Now, Just one final thing. I would like to pay my condolences to the family of Paddy Riley, who unfortunately passed away due to the coronavirus. He was only 57 years of age, from Carlow. May God rest you. None of us know what's around the corner. And guys, you know, we're nearly there. Keep washing your hands and stay safe. It's been an absolute pleasure doing videos for you guys. I will be back in a while. I'm just going to take a bit of a break to try and upskill myself. And you never know what's going around happen in the future. Have a wonderful weekend and thanks a million, guys. Take care. Lovely little tidy town. Lovely little town. It's not even a town, it's only a village. Or as they say in Germany, a village. An ambulance coming behind me here. I'm just going to let him on. Don't want to be getting in them lads' way. Rojo, Rojo. Still nothing. Not a single one.
Don't see any either, Ned.
Yes, Bo, I know. I haven't seen any. Neither have I. Haven't seen a single one, Ned.
Shut up, Eddie.
You shut up.
Shut up.
Well, here we are. And I knew I'd find one somewhere. And this is in County Roscommon, in the townland of Crana West, Glanduff. And they can see where the grass has been cut here in this area by the girl's family. And this is really, really sad. And it says, in loving memory of Rosaline Morris, Cam Brideswell, who died here tragically on the 18th of April, which is only a few days from now, 1982, aged 8 years. Rosaline Morris, may she rest in peace. So Rosaline was born in 1974. She died here at aged 8 on the 18th of April 1982. May she rest in peace. It's obvious, by the way, that this grass has been looked after here, that her family still come here to pay their respects. I was delighted to be able to stop there. Just to pay your respects for little Rosaline. She'd be 46 now if she was still with us. God bless her. 8 years old. And you can see by the way the grave is kept, it's not a grave, but the way the headstone is kept, that the family are out there all the time cutting the grass around it. That's freshly cut grass. It's either the family themselves or someone that lives close by is actually cutting the grass there, and it's very, very nice of them to do so. It's nice that someone even that died in 1982, which is a couple of years ago now, that they're still remembered. Because there, for the grace of God, go any of us. None of us know when it's our turn. I wonder, is Rosaline buried in that cemetery? I'm assuming she was a local girl. I don't know that area that it says on the headstone where she's from. I don't recognize it. It could be a local area, and then again it could be miles away. But it didn't say County Galway or anywhere. So I'm assuming she's from around these parts somewhere, God rest her. It's nice on the last day that I'm doing a vlog to be able to get a memorial. And Rosaline Morris, thank you, because it's a nice way to finish up on my domestic vlogs.
Sorry, I hate that word vlog. My domestic videos. And it's also nice for the first time in 2 years to get down to Roscommon, and that's another reason why I don't really want to do them anymore, because all the work I'm doing is very repetitive and there's no point in making a video just for the sake of making a video to try and get views and stuff. I don't go into that at all. If I've nothing worth posting, I just won't post anything. Because people are going to say, oh, all his videos are all the same. They're all the same. You know, I don't want that. I'm not going away, though. I remember that. I'm not going away. I just won't be doing any more domestic vlogs. Videos, vlogs, whatever you call them. I call them videos. Some people call them vlogs. Video log, vlog. I just don't like that word vlog. So it looks like Rosaline is the only one we're going to see. God bless her. It's 18 degrees outside now. And I can feel it. Excuse me. Oy. I'm just yawning. I'm not sneezing or coughing. There's a busy little garage there, but it's got all the stuff. There's a garden center open there. Oh Lord. There's one beside that post box that I missed. Flip it anyway. I just caught the flowers out of my corner of my eye, and I am sorry for if you know who was headstone is there. It's not really a headstone, it's only a tiny little plaque. But still, I don't like missing anything like that. I don't like missing anything like that at all. Now we're coming back into Athlone. I'll just drive in around. Now this place here, at one stage, was the busiest spot in the whole of the country. This was what used to be the truck stop. I'll just get out and give you a quick look. Now this is Mother Hubbard's, which was the truck stop for years and years and years when we were younger, when I started driving in 1992. This was the Mecca for truck drivers, and all that space up there where you can see in front of you there used to be full of lorries. But take a look at it now. Take a look at it now. It's just a sign of the times. Literally what happened here was that when the bypass opened, this place literally, and I'm not exaggerating,
went down overnight. All the trucks were going straight on for Galway, for Westport, for Mayo. This was the only road out of Dublin going west at one stage. You have a couple of old box van trailers parked up there. And that now is a motorcycle training place. I don't know whether they're using this area in here, but like, it's really sad to see, you know. Brings back memories. I remember Colm O'Gorman, is that the guy's name from RTE, came down here at one stage and he was interviewing drivers who were parked here because this was the place to eat, and it got so popular with truck drivers that car drivers started coming here as well, and you would literally have to scramble to get a table or to get a, between sort of 9 o'clock in the morning and half 11, 12 o'clock, you would not get a seat in here. There was queues of people. Queues of people, trucks parked all over here. You could have maybe 30 or 40 trucks parked here at any one time. Mother Hubbard's. The famous Mother Hubbard's. So if you ever want to know where it is, if you come on the N4, come off at Enfield and go on the National Road, you'll see it. I'll just take a look in here. In through the... There's a truck to have on that. I wonder, there's no registration number on it. Trucker special, four course meal, $15.95. I mean, it's still open, don't get me wrong, it's still open. Mother Hubbard's regular breakfast, $7.50. That's not bad value, and it's really nice inside. You can have a look there. It's really nicely laid out. Really nicely laid out. And there are people that still, because there are a lot of drivers that actually still come this road. And I'm sure they come in here for breakfast too. But it's nothing like it was. Absolutely nothing like it was. Oh, there you go. So that's Mother Hubbard's. If you're coming out the main road from Dublin, you come off at Enfield and follow the road from Enfield on the old road, and it'll bring you to this place here. Memories are made of this, Mother Hubbard's. Here's a little plaque to a guy called John Nolan. Happy birthday, son. 1976. John Nolan died here in 2000, which is 20 years ago. Now, I'm not sure the circumstances. Nice looking chap as well. Born in 1976 and he died here in the year 2000, 20 years ago. His family obviously take very good care of this as well. There's fresh flowers and it's all laid out with, you know, a little, that roly grass stuff. And God bless his soul, John Nolan. Well, there's a headstone. Oh, it's not a headstone, but it's a cross over there. And I'm not going to be able to stop at that either, unfortunately, because I just know where to pull in here. If I stopped here, and I'd love to stop here, I'd end up blocking the whole road up. There's some poor unfortunate that lost their life there on that junction. May they rest in peace. Very comfortable truck, you know, really smooth. Not really all that powerful. There's a 460 engine in this. It's not a powerful truck. Stevie Connolly by. I see they're in here. They've cleaned up all the rubbish that was left here. And the fencers are in now.
And hopefully that'll be the end of the nonsense in there. So I'll catch up with you later on, a little bit further on down the road. It's not so sunny here. The forecast is for sun, but I don't see any sign of it yet. Not that I'm particularly bothered. Most important thing at the moment is to be working, because I know there's an awful lot of people who are not working. And that ain't funny at all. So I'm just lucky to have a job. And I really mean that. In the current climate, the way things are. Be a bit bumpy and stuff until we get out onto the main road, but once we get out onto the main road we should be hunky dory. I would always choose a DAF over a Scania any day. And the reason is for pure living comfort. This, look, sit on the bed, make your lunch, put your laptop up there, whatever you want, you know, perfect, lovely big fridge, great storage, fantastic storage. And I like being able to touch the windscreen like that. I like that. I don't like being way back from the windscreen and trying to do this. I like to be up on top of the windscreen, and that's one of the reasons that I like the DAF. There's lots of other reasons as well. I like the layout of the DAF. The bed is extremely comfortable in the DAF. The only downside with the DAF is the gearbox and the power. Now, I've driven a 510 when I was at Dixon's, and they're a really good yoke to go. But the 460s, they're a bit light on power, but hey-ho, you can't have it all. Beside me, sitting in the middle lane, sitting right beside me in the middle lane. They just won't learn, you know. They just won't learn. Fucking yoke shouldn't be allowed on dual carriageways or motorways. Fucking nuisance. Now we're just coming into our first little village, Ballinalack. This place on the left hand side is very popular. There's loads of parking for trucks in there to the left. Huge big shop. It's obviously decimated like everything else by this virus that's going around. Sometimes you'll get them go safe speed vans hanging around on the path here. Not often, but sometimes you will. Nice little town. Here's the guards. Wouldn't expect to see that there now. Checkpoint just as you come out of the town. Actually, they're talking to one of their own. just on the running now to Carrigan-Shannon, County Leitrim. The sun came out briefly there, but it's gone back in again. I haven't been to this first collection, but it's near Cluny, I think, so it's not actually in Sligo. It's this side of Sligo, which is fine. All quiet here anyway. Big shopping centre over just over here. I'm past this roundabout. And it's normally very busy. Nothing open here, look. Nothing open, only... What is open in here? Tesco, that's it. Tesco's open.
100 meters at the roundabout, take the first exit onto Bypass Road, N4.
The problem people have is, you see, you know, when you're stuck at home like that for a lengthy period of time, you say, oh, you know, maybe I'll paint that skirting board, or maybe I'll do this. But you see, you can't, because you're not able to get any paint. You're not able to get any wood to fix things. I want to paint my garage door, I can't, because I have no paint. I need to get some sealant, can't get that either. So you really are stuck. This is a beautiful little town, Carrigan-Shannon, beautiful place. Lovely marina up here now, and there's a lovely hotel. And it's always very clean, very well looked after, very well kept. Oh, excuse me, oh, yawning there. Fruit and veg shop is open. It's a lot quieter here now than it normally would be. A lot quieter. There's the marina there in front. Ging's Riverside Bar for a Guinness. Wouldn't that be lovely? There's the marina in there. Loads of lovely little speedboats and yachts. And all sorts.
In 400 meters, it's at the roundabout. Continue straight to stay on N4.
Thank God you're going to the right. Thank God you're going to the right, because you were really starting to get up my nose. You really were. So this is the far side. There's a store that's open there, but I don't know. Terrible. I don't know how a lot of these companies are going to survive. Still have to pay rates, still have to pay bills, still have to pay rent. I don't know. Billions being lost, billions, I'd say. So, Sligo 52, Cluny 42. So, Cluny's 10 kilometres this side of Sligo. Boom! Well, we have a very nice bit of scenery here. Not too far from Boyle, County Roscommon, but we're still on the N4, which is the Dublin to Sligo road. Very, very nice landscape. If you're into greenery or you like green stuff, there's a load of it here. guy coming up behind me there fairly fast. I'm going to see if I can let him go on. Maybe he wants to overtake me, maybe he doesn't, but I give him the opportunity anyway by pulling in and let him go on. There he goes. Oh, very, very fashionable with your left and rights there, mister. So, look at this. Is always the way it's been for me. I'm like Stavros now, waving my hands around the place. You know, Stavros, you know. Hi, yeah, great. You know, I'm going down to Sligo. Down to Sligo, right? That's where I'm going. And I'm going to get some stuff and I'm going to put it in the trailer. And I'm going to close the doors and I'm going to bring it back to Dublin and I'm going to deliver it. Do you know, that's the way Stavros goes. Everything has to be, you know, every point, every word has to have some kind of a hand action with it. Do you know what I mean? So annoying. That is so, so annoying to watch. And we're just coming upon the first sign of the roadworks here. I know that they're eventually going to try and make a dual carriageway the whole way from Dublin down to Sligo, but it's just going to take a long time. But the last section of road, which is about 20 miles into Sligo, it's narrow, twisty road. So that's what they're trying to do here. This is going to be the beginning of it, I'd say, heading off over to the right. That's going to be the beginning of it there. And all this here is going to be bypassed. Including Castle Baldwin, which this place is. Another shop closed, garage gone, look, shut down. And there's another checkpoint up here. I'm sure it's a covert 19 checkpoint. Plenty of squad cars anyway. One, two, three, four of them. Four squad cars. Three in a van, three cars in a van. Is there, you have to ask the question, is there any need for five or six of them to be standing around there? Why do they need to have five or six of them? Would two of them not be enough? One stopping the traffic coming this way, the other stopping the traffic coming that way. Seems like a waste of resources.
At the roundabout, take the second exit and stay on N4.
That just can't be right. This can't be right, sure. Although I see a factory up there. I wonder is that it up there? I never even realized that this place was here.
I'm just sitting here. I got time. clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together, it's so beautiful, you and me. We're meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free.
Get out and have a look here, because I'm not happy about what I see behind me there.
lady in a wedding gown.
Yes, sir.
Get in the car?
Yes, sir.
See who's driving?
No, sir.
License plate?
Yes, sir. Georgia plates. Ban 1. BAN-ONE.
All right. Now, you boys just stay here and watch the car. There might be some vandals around them want to steal something. So you boys just stay here and keep your hands on the car until one of my associates arrives. And don't go home. Don't go to eat. And don't play with yourself. It wouldn't look nice on my highway. Oh, you can think about it, but don't.
So pretty, I first set my eye on a sweet Molly Malone.
As she wheeled her wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels alive, alive. A fishmonger, sure 'twas no wonder. So were her father and mother before. And they each wheeled their barrows through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels.
Cockles and mussels.